Hey everybody, welcome back to GDPG, and we are doing our holiday special.
Game Devs Play Games.
Little delayed there, buddy.
Hello, Game Devs Play Games, play your game holiday levels you sent us, we wish to enjoy.
There you go, exactly. Thank you for the best intro we've ever had. Now,
I know.
So we asked for a bunch of holiday themed Mario Maker levels, so we're gonna play them and we're gonna talk about them and
for those of you who responded to us, you get to see your level played, so awesome. All right, so we're gonna start this one off with
Koopa Klaus's Horrible Holiday.
Yes, and by Squadaloo on Reddit, which is where we got his thing from, but his name is Lane, L-A-Y-N-E, Lane.
Am I playing this one or are you?
You know, I've already played it, so have fun.
Ooh, well, I've got
you've got the controller. Do it.
Oh, yeah. I always feel wrong when I start with my thumb on the joystick.
Really?
It doesn't feel appropriate.
Oh, yeah, no, I can't use the joystick. Yep.
Alright.
Oh, it's gonna take us hours to get through these levels, isn't it?
Before we started this, Nathan was like, or I was like, well, I should set the timer just to make sure we hit our 10-minute minimum, and Nathan was just like, if we die once on any of these levels, it's gonna happen.
Yup.
Ooh, 1-up. Nice.
Yeah. The 1-up's pretty nice, because if you ended up getting this during the 100 Mario Challenge,
yeah, then I feel like that's something that a lot of people don't do too. I think that's probably the most frustrating thing when I play any levels on expert mode, is there are a lot of levels that are just obscenely difficult and don't have any one-ups. I'm just like, come on, man, you know I'm gonna be dying like crazy.
Oh yeah,
throw me a bone at least.
At least 3 bones.
Yeah, right,
because that's all you can collect. So far holiday theme wise, like, there's been some toyage going on with the bombs and stuff like that. That seems to be like the way that most people really, you know, they're like, oh man, toys, so bombs and stuff.
Oh, well, actually, I can still get up there because this is an infinitely generating. So, yeah, I kind of get the theme. I mean, it sort of is in the name, right? But it's sort of like a, the toy workshop.
Yeah.
Yep. Which it took me a second to see that, to get that. Like, I didn't quite catch that at first. Although, I feel like, well, I guess color-wise, is there any kind of theme going on? Like, I feel like
there's a lot of red and greens going on. Not that you would know that.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
Can you control the color of the shoe boot thing? I know there's the high heel version, right?
Yeah. The only difference is the high heel or the regular one. So if you notice right now, you're on a reindeer.
I was definitely looking at those little the paths,
wondering why they were there. First time I played it too, I was like, I don't understand why I'm looking at these. And then all of a sudden, I saw the windows, like, or the little ice block. I was like, oh my god! And look, they have little rockets on their feet. Oh, they're so adorable.
That actually is kind of adorable. I mean, maybe I'm partial to it because I did it in one of my levels too. But I really love it when people use the actual level assets to make art.
Yeah.
It's like in Mariovania when I made the little skull faces and stuff.
It's fun.
It helps.
You can jump on those, by the way.
I know.
As long as you jump on them.
I know.
I'm just saying.
I'm not in any immediate danger. I got this.
Oh, that's okay.
Ooh, double checkpoint.
Double checkpoint.
You know, it's not
always gotta love a good double checkpoint.
And there's never a double checkpoint in traditional Mario, right?
No, there's not, but it does get to the point where things become a little difficult. This is clever, and I love it. So, I've seen a few of this guy's levels on the Reddit, and he is actually pretty good stuff. So, I may be watching out for his levels here and there.
Yeah, I like this. For a boss battle, I feel like this is...
You crushed him. So there was Santa.
Oh!
And then, well, bam, look at that.
Wait, was Koopa Santa in that sense?
Yep.
Okay. And it's like a wreath. Christmas wreath.
Exactly.
Although I feel like there should be a one-up right in the center here.
Oh, that would have been good. Maybe there's like a block. Like, you know, climb up the thing, get a block.
I mean,
eh.
You know, I know we hate sound effects in Mario Maker. I feel like this is at least a little bit better.
Oh, it's not annoying. That's what's important.
Yeah, this one's not annoying. I feel like I'm still not a fan of it, but like, it's okay. I'm not actually going to complain about that one. It's kind of nice to get that cheer when you actually beat the level.
Actually do something
and
rewarding. Yes.
My favorite part is the fact that our exit wasn't blocked this time and Mario didn't go into like a conniption fit.
This would be really sad. Yeah.
Lane.
But yeah,
great
that was
job.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So
what was
boom.
His name on the
Thanks
the
for
Reddit?
That. Squadaloo.
Squadaloo.
You'll recognize him by the brown Kamek, and I think he has like some reward. I've only like just got into the Reddit some award, like the Game of the Year award or Level of the Year award, something like that. I don't know.
Either way, great level flow. I felt that the difficulty was actually really spot on. Like, it was challenging enough to like have me, you know, going in and out of getting damaged and collecting more power ups. Like,
exactly.
Power ups were very well placed. And
there
I
are just
the pacing was great
a little bit of obvious secrets is another good way of looking at some of the things like that life up mushroom you found there. That was good.
Yes. All right. So we are playing Christmas Time in the Kingdom by Marshall or on the subreddit, Phoenix_Cage.
Phoenix Cage.
Yeah, so we got this one off of the Reddit also, and this time Intangible's going to be playing this.
He said this was mostly just like a fun themed level. So you were talking before about like art. And just, all the snow. All right.
Snow?
The ground is ice, and then the
oh, and things, they're all white blocks.
They're all white blocks.
Like snow covered.
It's a themed level.
You know, one thing I always kind of wished is that they would let us change elements in the background. Because, you know, there's all the, like, green hills and stuff.
Well, you can have, like, some amount of control. Oh, come on.
In the background. No. I mean, if you, like...
Oh, you suck. I just want a shoe. I just want my shoe. Okay.
If you shuffle around some of the, like, ground, you can kind of change where the props appear in the background. But...
Yeah, and then once you get the one you want, you can delete all the blocks around it and just...
Yeah, it's just, like, it's so much of a hassle to actually get what you want out of it. Like, I think that the aesthetic of this level would really be complete if there was a way to just remove the green hills entirely. Just make it white, have the clouds in the background, and that'd be good.
Yeah, that would actually
feel very wintry.
I am wondering why he chose the fireballs, but I'm not questioning it because there's actually something kind of satisfying about running around like all these little
Do you slide when you're wearing the boot?
Yes, but ever so slightly.
Oh,
like,
okay.
You can stop on a dime is where it's at.
Yeah, I know that at least in Mario Maker, I don't know if this is true for classic Mario.
Go down there.
But if you jump while sliding on ice, you will immediately stop sliding.
Yes.
And so in a way that can actually make some ice levels a little too easy. But I understand why the designers of this game would have wanted to make it that way, because otherwise jumping might be a nightmare.
So
I've seen that in a lot of 3D platformers, and it's horrible. So
why do you think the arrows there?
I don't know. I mean, maybe it's to draw your attention to the fact that spawning out of there?
Oh, and there's a little smokestack coming out of the house.
There's got to be a no secret up there.
That's okay. You know what? The smokestack you wouldn't even see unless you actually got up there. So that's the reward
true.
In itself.
Yeah, right. I feel
Where does
like
this door
they could
go?
Still
I'm guessing
up.
The other door. All right.
There is a mechanical benefit to going in and out of the door, though, isn't there? I think it resets
things. Yeah.
It doesn't
those
reset
guys
items, though, does it?
It won't reset, like, just certain destroyed blocks. Oh, super. Why are you breaking things? No, I want that. I want that. Oh, no.
Whoa!
Oh, I found a thing.
Did not expect that.
Huh.
So, okay, as far as the aesthetic goes,
do
you think that those guys mean anything? Or is it just there to hide a secret, you think?
You know what? I honestly don't know. Oh, come on.
Might as well get another flower.
Oh, you suck. I want... Wait for it.
Do better, Mo.
I'm gonna get on the house, and then I'm gonna climb on those guys... And I'm going to find the super secret. And that's what's going to happen here.
You're going to be sorely disappointed if there's no super secret.
You don't want to see me disappointed. Joust. I win. All right. Barely. See if I can get... Oh, I'm almost out of time.
Oh, there's... Yeah, there's got to be a secret up there. I mean, you could probably just jump out of the boot and then bounce your way up there.
Aww.
And there's no spin jumps, right?
So... Look at that little guy. All right. And...
You think that's supposed to just be like a shortcut, I guess?
Yeah, maybe. So, it's like, there's no spin jump, so the boot is really the only way to do it. And I don't think it went anywhere. Oh,
I mean, fun either way. Well, I mean, the level itself wasn't particularly challenging. The aesthetic was kind of nice.
There was something, as I said, there was something a little satisfying about just, like, running around and just, like, with the multi-layers and dealing with all the enemies. It kind of reminded me of old-style platformers like Joust or things like that, where there's a lot going on and you can take your different routes.
And level design in that way, I don't know how much time he actually spent, like, choosing exactly where all those little platforms are.
If they were just placed randomly.
But that is either a style of level design in and of itself.
That's true.
It's not very common, and it's generally because it's hard to build a game around that. But it can be really fun if it's done well. And I think, like, while this wasn't challenging, it was kind of satisfying, too. I understand what you mean.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that was... Awesome.
Christmas Time in the Kingdom by Marshall.
Christmas Time in the Kingdom by Marshall, otherwise known as... Phoenix Cage. Thank you for your level.
Boom.
So we are on to Merry Mega Man X Xmas.
X Xmas.
There needs to be like one more X in there.
Uh-oh. No. Wait. Can you play as Mega Man X? There's no Mega Man X. It's only Mega Man. Unless there's armor pieces. All right, now I expect armor pieces.
You mean like the costume?
Yeah, whatever.
I don't know. I haven't gotten all the costumes. I don't know what there is in here. So who made this? Mega Mario?
This was done by Mega Mario. Yeah, Mega Mario 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh my. I already lost the Mario costume.
Well done.
I was distracted
by the...
You
lost the Mario costume? Can't talk and brain at the same time?
All right.
You know what's cool about the Mega Man?
I saw the clouds, man, and I was like, they're dropping clouds.
It's the snow. All right. Press up. It is. Press up. No, press down. Press down.
No! Oh, man. Okay, so...
You had one job.
I know in the last one level job. I was talking about how jumping makes... or fixes the momentum, and it makes ice levels easy. I'm gonna eat my words.
Uh-huh. Just like this dry bones here is gonna eat you.
How do they make the clouds fall like that? I didn't know you could do that.
I imagine they probably either they probably put them on some, like, I guess the best way to say it is like a motion thing that kind of like these wires, for instance. You can
and just like
those.
Put and just like not have like an end point, so they just fall off.
Yeah.
if that's how they did it, that's actually kind of clever. I like that. Meager Mans!
So, uh-oh.
This is what I get for dilly-dally.
Oh, dilly-dally.
I actually kind of like that.
That was pretty fun.
Especially because
punishing
if you...
Punishing you for not going fast enough. Aww.
Well. Yeah, exactly. I mean, if you do make it there in time, too, then it just becomes, like, this stress platform run where you're just like, oh, God. Will I be able to make it?
I like that little guy who flies at you right there. It's like, ah!
Whoop.
Oh, I would have died there.
I like where the chain chomps are placed, because I feel like if you're paying attention, it gives you enough time to stop and, like, brace yourself for the inevitable.
Whoop. Uh-oh. All right, you know, don't hit the pal block.
I tried. I tried to grab it. Wait, is this... Yeah, no, I thought I should have been able to grab it, right? Right?
You're playing in regular Mario.
It is Mario 1?
Yeah, man.
Sometimes I have a hard time telling the difference.
Get up there. Get up there. Oh!
Right, you taught me this, that I can just sit on these guys, which I did not know.
But
your wings level.
Wings. Teaching players things.
Seriously.
Uh-oh.
You can just go under them, yeah?
Well. Yep. You can.
Oh!
Red cannonball. Oh, red cannonball.
That was a good spot for a checkpoint too.
Yeah.
Good placement.
And then immediately rewards you with some Mario action instead of forcing the mushroom on you. You better go. Oh, no.
I like the level design in this so far, actually.
It's fun.
The challenges are a lot more, I think, intelligent than... And not to say that that the other levels we've played were at all dumb, but, like, they're just more... They're really interesting. Like, they're not super complicated, but I feel like I haven't really seen these, many of these challenges.
I mean, even these platforms right here, you see them going at the arc, and then it leads up into this point right here. And you got the cannon shooting at you, and the cannons, the platforms alternate up and down.
So where do you think you see the theming in this?
Well, I think it's a combination of two things. It's trying to be a Christmas level as well as a Mega Man thing. You really suck at this. Like those platforms moving up and down right there with the cannons on them, oh, that's totally a Mega Man thing.
Oh, that's true. That's without a doubt.
But then the other things, like the shapes done with the levels, I can probably finish an entire analysis in the time it'll take you. But like the shapes are done in a very, holiday.
Wait, did they turn from coins into the
They were always
shells?
Coins.
No. When I hit the P block, or the P switch.
Oh, they turn into the guys into bricks.
The blue. No, they weren't bricks. They turned into the maybe I'm crazy.
The Christmas tree.
Yeah, that's holiday. And look at all those one ups. I feel like I'm missing something. Oh, I need to
get.
There it is.
One of those things like you can't see, I guess, if you're playing because you're just.
Oops. Oh boy.
Try not to miss every.
I have to hit the.
Just hit the turtle and then hit the turtle into the P.
Oh yeah, you're right. Whoa! I didn't notice that Mega Man does the little like slide thing. Well, that worked out swell.
I got nothing.
Mega Man does the... When he's...
I mean, there's another way you can do this. Oh, yeah. I didn't actually realize that. That's awesome. It's to the right.
To the right?
What you seek is to the right. Nope.
I wish I had a ground pound red by now. Ooh, ah, ooh. Ooh. Oh, you mean this guy?
Yep.
I'm gonna get me another mushroom. Sorry, folks.
No, it's okay. We'll wait for you.
It's better than replaying the level after I mess it up like an idiot.
Boom. Oh, you were robbed.
Son of a bitch. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh
no.
Well, we got a checkpoint. It's okay. It's fine. Okay.
Forward.
I was crazy. No, I thought that those coins with the wings turned into the blue shells. I don't know what they're called, but it's just shooting out blue shells to mess with me.
I don't think that's why I was doing it. I do think it's succeeding in messing with you.
That's true.
So this level has done two things. If you remember earlier, you had that one POW block that you had to hit on that conveyor belt.
Well, yes.
Just get on the vine. You're so close. Oh, no. just hit him. Just...
No! No! I swear, man. Oh, no, I can't kill the Gucci. You can't kill Gucci with a star. You just run on top of them.
Right. Well, you know, do it the way you're supposed to, then.
Yeah, I know. You can't even go through them, either. Like, you can't... Actually, that's kind of clever. Because you can't get through these guys. I have to jump. All right. So it's a good way to force the player to actually finish the thing that you designed.
Yeah, it's basically using a key. It's locking the level up.
There we go. One of these days, Chris. One of these days.
Oh,
Christmas
tree. See that tree? See that tree? Here's a different one.
Just to make sure you finish with Mega Man. Aw, and all the one-ups. Yes! I did it.
pretty satisfying.
Oh, I didn't know.
This has a boss level that has no boss.
I mean, the boss was the collective. It was the hive mind.
Yeah, and it had the music of the boss.
So
pretty satisfying.
What did you think about the level in general? I actually thought it was... I mean, I already kind of spoke my piece, but I think it delivered a very fun and interesting experience that I haven't really gotten out of a lot of Mario Maker levels yet.
No, absolutely. A lot of its design was very, very clever. It was... I wouldn't say, like, the precision was, like, all the way up there as far as exactly where they were trying to go with it. But there was... But as we said before, like, clever, the conveyor belts being really obnoxious, but then moving into having a mini boss with that little pal block and then teaching you that that's going to be the boss later in the level.
Yeah.
And that's very important. That was very cool of them. And then, you know, showing you what's to come with that one Christmas tree leading to another Christmas tree. It's pretty cool.
It was fun.
So, yeah. Boom.
Well, thank you, Mega Mario. That was a great level. All right. We are on to Tingle All the Way, which is a level submitted by Todd Luck. But made by Max's,
and this is from Google Plus.
Yeah, we got this submitted on the Google Plus Mario Maker page.
Oh, this is I'm already not happy about this. All right.
You don't like auto scrolls?
No. I love auto scrolls. I don't like playing in them though. I'm dead.
You had impeccable timing for your death.
Well, it was because I love auto scrolls and everything about them. It's just like, you know when the end is coming and there's nothing you can do about it.
That's fair. Although recovering from those
I want that and I can't have it.
Yeah, and there's just enough space above that too to where you can, if you get it, yeah, you'll watch it go all the way and then down that little portal.
And now I get to see everything that I'm never gonna get to have.
Yep.
It's funny. It's an auto scroll level that is a level, and at the same time, has the music going on because of the musical blocks.
Oh, is that?
You didn't realize that?
Do you think that was playing above you the whole time?
Yeah, man. Oh no.
That's actually kind of clever. I was wondering about that.
There's stuff in here. I want that.
Was it really?
I want that thing. I want that. Why would you do that to me?
What came out?
It's a mushroom. It's a mushroom inside. I want it.
That is kind of mean.
Why, Max?
I actually really like that. Like, it's one thing to just, like, have a music level, because there's a lot of those, right? Especially the don't moves. They'll often have, like, music incorporated into them, because it's like, you know, it makes the don't move more interesting.
Oh, no.
But, like, they actually used the music as, like, they set the stage with it and still had a legitimate level.
Yeah.
And, wow. Yeah, like, thematically speaking, this was awesome.
It had the level, it had the music, which I haven't seen yet. I mean, I'm sure people have done it, but...
I guess the little music symbols are that much more appropriate in the name.
The name is very appropriate, yeah.
But, like... I like, too, that there was sort of that, like, intermission where you, like, go through the music section. Like, you're like, oh, that's how this was done. And then you go back and you go do the rest of the level.
It gives you a different feel, though, for that, for Jingle All the Way, because you're like, oh, Jingle Bells. Oh, my God, I'm dead. I just fell in a hole. I'm dead. Like, that's kind of how it makes you feel, And then it gives you a nice little intermission with that little coins, and then it puts you right back into it again.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to vote this one as having the best Christmas tree so far. It was a pretty intense Christmas tree, I got to say. And there were some good ones so far, too. But cool. Well, thank you, Maxes, for making this level. And thank you to Todd Luck for submitting that level. All right. So, Mario Goes Christmas Shopping. This is made by Webby Bud.
Webby Bud. Webby Bud.
Webby Bud.
I think... The name is like Webby Wife on Reddit or something.
You know better than I. You spend more time on there. But it was submitted by Phoenix Cage.
Yes, it was.
Because this guy did a solid for him. Is that a mushroom behind the vine? I see red.
Figure it out. It's like orangish.
I don't know.
It's like background of the level. I'm not really sure.
Yeah.
Boom.
I feel like it's got to be.
Because
what else would be? Oh, wait, also, I like the use of the that path right here. It looks like it's holding up a little, like, What are they called? The things you put over doors?
Oh, it does. That's really clever. I didn't even realize that.
Did I? Was that a one-up that I got at first? Or was
that
a...
The first time it was a one-up, yeah.
Oh, I thought it was a red mushroom. I was like, wait, but I already became Big Mario. When did this happen? That I took damage.
So if you notice right there, those are chairs, and that's tables. And somebody's just chilling out.
Food. Oh, hell yeah.
Goomba on a rail. He's just trying to eat. Look at that food. Look at that.
Dude, family massacre over here.
Aw, you deserve that.
Whatever.
That was revenge for the family.
Food.
Get it. Yeah.
I didn't read it. I'm sorry. Oh.
You're missing out on so much fun stuff.
Should I go down here?
You should.
It's one of those levels where I'm like, I feel like...
Okay, you should go to the left. And like, okay back to the... So go down there, right? Yeah, and go down that way. Actually, you really don't need to, but just go down it anyway.
I'll take this with me.
Whatever. You're going to feel how useless it is. And that's how useless it was. You should have just trusted me.
I'm happy I brought it. Yeah.
All right, so boom. It unlocks this area with all the coins.
Oh, man.
Right? And so, then...
I'm glad you told me to slow down, too, because my initial reaction was, oh, God, it's a puzzle level where I'm never going to know what I'm doing, and I'm forever roaming aimlessly. So I was just going.
Fair.
But there's a lot more to see. Whoa! Oh, okay. That was not what I expected.
Did you know that heel is stronger than the other one?
The boot?
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
It destroys more stuff.
Really?
Yep.
I mean, it has the... Oops.
Alright, well... What,
isn't it the one that has like a... Maybe it's not a ground pound, but if you fall a certain distance, doesn't it break blocks?
Something like that.
Yeah, I guess the boot doesn't do that.
Sold.
Oh no.
Out. You don't get none.
Oh man, but I want the toys.
Nope.
Ha! What if I just got myself stuck there?
That would have been awesome.
Oh, it fixed itself. Ah! That's one effect that I don't think I've ever used myself.
That one?
Squiggly.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Not sold out here. Oh dang.
There's a Mario somewhere in there. I'm gonna let you know now that those blocks don't have really, they're just coins in them. I just want you to know, because I did too, where I was like, I'm gonna get them. I'm gonna get those blocks.
How did you get the second one though? That one's totally blocked
off. I don't actually remember, to be honest.
Just like glitch your way through it. Did I see everything?
I think in this area you did. There's that area off to the left, but I can't figure out how to get to it, so.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know.
Oh, maybe that's the answer. Wait, no, you can't take... Can you pick that up?
I don't think you can take it off the rail.
Sad day.
I know, right? Oh, wait, I haven't gone into any of these. So let's see what's in here.
We're going shopping.
Dude, right? Oh, man, that's a... Oh, I want that! I need it! Oh
no.
I need that! Oh, well, you could take...
You take one of those
spring.
With you. Now, you can probably get back in the boot, can't you?
No, you can't hold things when you're in the boot. That's, like, the main disadvantage of it. But I could always go back for it.
Oh, no.
Every time.
Oh, gotcha.
Oh, I lost my hat. Aww. It's okay. I'll get the spiky hat.
No, you don't have cool swag. Oh, that's not going to help you.
My swag.
Aww.
My swag.
Bouncy thing doesn't help. What are you doing, man?
I'm figuring it out, man.
Oh.
I got me a
spring. Oh. Can't throw up. I mean, you can't throw upward.
I know.
Not throw
I'm trying
up.
To... Maybe if I do... No.
Do better, more better.
I think it's just enough. Huh. Nope. Well, I think that solves that.
Somebody's going to do it. And they're going to tell us how. We're going to be like, oh.
Was there actually anything up there?
No, it's to the left. Like, if you go to the left, boom.
Like, we see all the spikes, right?
And then you see the mushroom. And then there's a tunnel, though, so there could be a number of ways of getting up there.
Yeah, I feel like there's got to be a pipe that'll take us there.
All right, let's figure it out. Moving forward.
Maybe it's one of these. Huh? Huh? Nope. All right. Great talk. Ah, didn't give me this time, Goom.
You had to open your mouth, didn't you?
Hmm, I'm good at Mario. I'm great at...
At least you got the bouncy thing, right? Because that's what my... Ah, you're good.
Sometimes Chris isn't good at seeing platforms that you can jump through.
Oh my.
It's fine, we got total... There's tons of 1-ups. Right? Right? That redeems it, right? Right?
If whatever matters to you, man.
Ah!
I mean, it's like you're trying to suck this much.
I'm getting, it's not even...
It's, oh!
I got nothing, man.
Dude, it's not you're just supposed just... to be shopping right now. Why is this so hard for
shopping
you?
Shopping is hard! Hey, man, shopping...
Maybe it's a metaphor. Maybe it's like this is how hard our holiday seasons are now.
This is the shit people have to go through for the holidays.
All those bombs. Oh.
Well, that's one way to get over there.
You only got one more. Oh.
Boom jams. They're really good at hiding these, the one-ups in the stage.
But in placing them in a certain space where you, like, you're going to jump and feel rewarded for having found it.
This one was good, too, because we had two rows of coins, and the left had three coins and the other had four. It was like, why is there asymmetry going on? Maybe there's something
happening. I want to know.
I'm going to jump over there and find out.
I'm going to find out.
And then I found out, because there was asymmetry. Like this.
Just, oh.
Boom jams. Look at that.
Yeah, but what if you hit, oh, wait, you know what? You gotta find out. Oh, I was gonna say, you gotta find out how to get down the tunnel.
Whoa!
All of the P blocks. Hit the P blocks. Hit them all.
I'm gonna hit all the P blocks.
You hit the P blocks?
I hit all the P blocks.
Congratulations. You win. Oh,
yes!
You got the thing you always wanted.
Yes!
Christmas is the best.
Oh, I always forget that the P blocks stop the, that. These. Treadmills, whatever they're called. Treads?
I don't know.
They're basically treadmills.
I know the names of most of the monsters in the, you know, in the Koopa Kingdom, but I do not know...
The names of the objects.
The objects,
the platforms.
Yes.
So this level seems decently long, at least so long as you choose to explore it.
I was going
to
say, there's a lot of exploration with it.
Oh, I can break that now.
Look at you. You got a special hat.
Dang, mans. Oh, they're going to take my hat.
No, don't. Shoot them. Shoot them.
Yeah.
They're just toys.
That's right.
Is what the sign said outside.
I have a fire flower. I forget these things.
My gosh. You're so bad at Mario.
Oh.
That's not how that's supposed to go.
I like the toys. Oh, well, there's that. Cool. Great. I'm going to go on a clown thing.
Get it.
Clown balloon. What are these things called? I keep calling them clown balloons, but
people,
I'm pretty
sure... People, for the most part, just call them balloons or clown balloons. Not even kidding you.
Yeah? Okay. I'm glad I'm not in the minority here. Minority.
The minority.
Minority.
That's how you say minority, then you are not within a minority. Minority. But whatever.
Double checkpoint. I feel like...
I'm making fun of English people. That's what I'm getting at.
Alright, but English people are...
You always say things like you're English. It's really weird.
Do I really?
Yeah.
I know Cujo makes fun of me a lot on the show, because he's like, oh, what are we in London now? Like,
it's because he makes fun of everything that everybody does. And says, including himself, and it's just like, dude, you know, just let it go. Sometimes people say things weird ways.
Right?
By accident. It's okay.
Dude, this is like...
Wait. That is my favorite part of this level.
That is kind of perfect.
Just
I like
the,
it a
the,
lot.
The jingling from the coins, that's
Wee-wee.
Awesome.
Wee. Awesome. You know, I think it's...
You're on a little bow, and you get Mario for Christmas.
That's your present.
Although you are stuck right there.
We're like... our head is sticking out of the present, so Mario can breathe.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's important. I don't know if you've ever received a kitten in a box for Christmas.
No, and I'm happy that I haven't because I would feel
terrible. My parents didn't learn after the first time.
So,
I hope they don't watch this.
I gotta say, I do love that at least four out of the five levels that we played had a Christmas tree at the end. This is my nice. It's like, yeah. It feels very, like, conclusive for a holiday-themed, at least a Christmassy-themed.
It was rather Christmassy versus being holidays-ish.
But, like, I think that's simply because there's more people that are into Christmas than a lot of other holidays, and that's fine. Like,
Certainly in America, the majority of it, but regardless, like, in holidays in general, like, for me, Christmas is whatever. It's just, I like the holiday season because people, at least around that time, tend to be happier. And that's what this was about.
Yeah.
It's about being happy and playing happy. Mario and then being angry sometimes, but still mostly being happy because you're happy because you're angry.
Anyway, thank you, Webby Bud, for making this level, and thank you, Phoenix Cage, for submitting this level to us.
The boom!
And that's actually all the levels we have.
Yeah. Yeah. Send us more levels.
Yeah, send us more levels. While we may not be doing any more holiday stuff for Mario Maker, at least, we would still love to check out other levels that other people in the Mario Maker community.
And I will post more on the Reddit. The name's Intangible, so you'd be like, "Oh, it's that jerk who keeps telling me to send him my levels." I'll do that. That's me. So, boom. Talk to you. Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Happy holidays. Ooh.
That was a very...